for Hawaii. You're watching Take Two.
It's probably odd to say, but the eruption situation on the Big Island is probably going about as good as it can be, considering that, you know, we have the active volcano erupting. If you ask me what I think the biggest hazard is, outside of the chance for increased lava flow or something like that, at this moment, I would probably say the most hazardous thing would be the chance for VOG and that affecting especially Kapuna and Keiki respiratory systems. So let's talk about that for a few minutes this morning with a doctor. Not a physician, but a doctor of meteorology. Dr. Stephen Businger joins us once again to give us his perspective on the potential danger from VOG produced by the Mauna Loa volcano. Good morning, Dr. Businger. Thanks for joining us once again this morning.
Yes, thank you for having me on, and hello, everybody.
Now, we don't need to get into why VOG is bad for you. For the purposes of this interview, let's just assume that VOG is in your lungs, that's bad. If VOG is not in your lungs, it's good. It's that simple, and we can discuss the actual thing we want to talk about here. What would happen, so if more dense VOG develops, if more VOG develops on the Big Island, and even now, where would it go? How do we know where it goes?
Well, my team at the University of Hawaii has been modeling VOG for quite a while. In 2010, we first started operational forecasting of the movement and dispersion of VOG. It's part of a program called VOG Measurement and Prediction Program. And it's available on the web at weather.hawaii.edu. And essentially, we get the emissions from the Hawaii Volcano Observatory, that's USGS. And we also get an indication of what the temperature is at the surface, how hot is the lava, where these emissions are occurring. And then the VOG model is quite sophisticated. It has a plume model, which drives the VOG up into the atmosphere in the vertical. And then it has a weather model input, which gives winds and stability and tells us where the VOG is going to go.
Okay, so we can actually show the model, I think, on your webpage and see what it looks like. This is what it's looked like. And Colby, if you can click the plus sign in the top right-hand corner to enlarge the actual map part of it. And it shows, I mean, you can see a lot of stuff on this. I'll just go over it real quick. I mean, you can see SO2, SE4 emissions on the top left that you can switch back and forth from. It shows percent of concentration. You can also click from moderate threshold to unhealthy to hazardous threshold, and it shows you not only now where is the VOG, but where it's going to be. Now, Dr. Businger, it's not simply a wind model that's put in here. I mean, that would be easy to develop, right? But there's a lot more that goes into it. What specific information, on top of what you've already said, does it give to the users?
Well, it gives the probability that a certain concentration will be exceeded. So what we do with this model is we run it many, many times with very slight variations to simulate the chaos, if you will, in the atmosphere. And as a result, we get a product which is a bit like precipitation. You know, we usually predict rainfall in terms of what is the likelihood of that rain will happen. There's a 50% chance of rain today or an 80% chance of rain. And so with VOG, that's what we do. We encapsulate that crazy chaos in the atmosphere, and we provide a product which gives you the chance that the VOG is going to be unhealthy. And that's very, very useful, I think, to the public, because then you can make decisions. And the VOG model goes out about 2 days into the future.
I think it's tremendously valuable to people to see, especially if they have issues with it, our Kapuna and our Keiki. You want to make sure that you're not breathing this stuff in. It's an excellent tool, Dr. Businger. The way you described it, we run it many, many times. I guess the first thing I thought of was like, one of those Avengers superhero movies, and they have all these multiple universes, and all these universes are based on if something else happened in your life, in anyone's life, then it would follow a certain future. That's what you do basically with this model and a lot of weather models that we have across the board. Now, if we get, let me ask you this, Dr. Businger, if we get more dense fog from the eruption and we get a southeast wind, you know, like in 2018, that could affect Maui County and in turn maybe Oahu. Now, how unhealthy is it compared to on the Big Island? Is it dispersed enough by the time it gets to over Oahu that it's not as unhealthy anyway?
Yeah, you know, one of the advantages of having a volcanic eruption that is pretty high in elevation is that it puts the fog into a part of the atmosphere that is away from sea level. And therefore, most of the fog is actually going to be in the middle layers of the atmosphere where, you know, airplanes fly and so forth. So it's a problem for general aviation. But it's not that much as getting to the surface, which is very, very fortunate. And of course, that's also good from the standpoint that the lava is erupting at relatively high elevations above 10,000 feet and are not currently a threat to any communities.
I mean, there could be exceptions to the great point about it going up into the higher levels of the atmosphere. But I mean, if we had a cap in the atmosphere, an inversion, and it kept it all down closer to the surface, that wouldn't be good. But anyway, this is a very good product. I wanted to show everybody. I wanted to, you created it, and I wanted everybody to see it because, especially now, we want everybody to log in and check that out. And they can, certainly.
I want to give a nod to my teammate in creating this model. Her name is Dr. Nadia Moiseva, and she is a PhD modeler and has done terrific work over the last couple of years to improve the model.
Okay, thank you. Well, thanks to her, too. We really appreciate it, Dr. Businger. We hope to have you on in the future to talk about other things.